The ship ahead just transmitted a message to the asteroid storage facility. They're requesting to be resupplied with Ketracel-White.
Looks like we've come to the right place.
The ship beamed down 110 empty canisters. Now the storage facility is beaming up 110 full ones.
Everything ready, Chief?
We've got 83 empty canisters standing by and one not so empty. 90 isotons of enriched ultridium. Should take care of the entire storage facility and everything else within 800 kilometers.
Which means we have to be 900 kilometers away before the bomb goes off.
The other ship is leaving orbit.
Dax.
The entire exchange took 92.3 seconds.
I've asked for 84 canisters of Ketracel-White. Excellent. They're acknowledging my request.
Chief, set the detonator for 3 minutes.
Detonator set.
3 minutes? If it takes 92.3 seconds to make the exchange, that doesn't give us much time, sir.
That doesn't give the Jem'Hadar much time to detect the explosive either. Commander, beam down the canisters.
Canisters away.
I hope whoever's in charge down there hasn't taken a lunch break.
The Jem'Hadar don't eat, Nog.
That's good. How do we know they're Jem'Hadar?
Relax, Cadet. Everything's on schedule. They've just beamed 84 canisters of white into our cargo bay.
I've acknowledged receipt and requested clearance for departure.
Good. Prepare to go to warp.
Standing by.
Captain, I think we have a problem. They've just raised the security net.
Repeat our request for clearance.
They're not responding.
If they don't shut down that net before the bomb goes off, we don't have a chance.
1 minute, 30 seconds to detonation.
Do you think they found the bomb?
I doubt it, not this fast.
Then why aren't they letting us go?
That's a good question.
Captain, they're responding. They're ordering us to stand by.
For what?
They're not saying.
1 minute, 15 seconds.
Chief, can we punch a hole in the security net?
Sure. It can take a couple of minutes.
We don't have a couple of minutes. What if we disable the net's power generator?
Explosion will do that.
Well, that won't do us much good.
1 minute.
Maybe it will. When the generator's destroyed, the net will come down. All we have to do is to time it so that we're moving fast enough at the moment of detonation to avoid being caught in the explosion.
But not so fast that we smash into the net before it's deactivated.
It's tricky.
Not if we time it right.
Let's see. A radial geodesic and a 39 Cochrane warp field. Contracts normal space at a rate of...
We have to go to full impulse 1.3 seconds before the bomb detonates.
Dax?
The computer agrees with Julian.
Well, of course it does. They think alike.
Turning over piloting controls to the main computer. Set.
Time.
22 seconds until the explosion.
22 seconds. That's plenty of time.
See, Cadet, there's nothing to worry about.
Must have gone off early.
Dax, get us out of here.
According to plan, but I'm sure Starfleet will be quite satisfied with the results.
I agree, Mr. Garrick. Well done, old man. How bad is it, Chief?
It doesn't look good. I'm gonna have to switch to auxiliary life support. Deflectors are down, guidance systems shot, and...
And what?
The core matrix is fried. We don't have warp drive.
Well, forgive my ignorance, but if we don't have warp drive, how long is it going to take us to reach the closest Federation starbase?
A long time, Mr. Garrick.
How long?
17 years, 2 months, and 3 days. Give or take an hour.